Hi, my name is Priya Roy, and I'm an AWS cloud economist based in Sydney. Today, I'm here with Adrian Jans, the General Manager of Cloud Data and Analytics at ANZ Bank, to talk about ANZ Bank's cloud strategy, the value they've realized on AWS, and where they're headed in their cloud journey. Thanks for joining us today, Adrian.
Thanks, Priya. Excited to be here.
In this session, we'll begin with an overview of how organizations can conceptualize the value of cloud using AWS's cloud value framework. Then I'll hand over to Adrian to talk through ANZ Bank's cloud strategy, using a deep dive into ANZ Bank's pricing applications as a case study, and then discussing what's next for ANZ Bank in the cloud. Most businesses rely on a number of legacy applications that require significant and ongoing infrastructure investments to deliver on performance, resiliency, and security requirements. When moving to cloud, there are benefits across all of these domains. And to consolidate thinking about the business value of cloud, AWS has developed a five-pillar framework called the Cloud Value Framework. This framework is designed to help organizations think through the various aspects of value they can realize on the cloud. The first pillar is cost savings. This is specifically in regard to infrastructure cost savings or cost avoidance. That is, how much money can a business save by running their infrastructure in the cloud versus on-premises? On-premises, companies have to pay for cooling, power, and security on top of expensive hardware that must be provisioned on the basis of future usage that may or may not actually occur. Meanwhile, through cloud's pay-as-you-go model, in which companies only pay for what they use, organizations can realize significant savings. The second pillar is staff productivity. This pillar is looking at how your staff might become more efficient by operating on the cloud versus on-premises. Many organizations are able to have more VMs or more storage terabytes managed per admin, making each worker more productive and freeing up time for those people to work on more innovative, experimental tasks. The third pillar is operational resilience. This pillar is focused on how security, unplanned downtime, outages, and other operational aspects are improved by being on the cloud. The fourth pillar is business agility. This pillar looks at innovation and experimentation. How quickly can features get to market? How many processes can be automated? How many fewer errors are made along the way? And how does that impact the end user's satisfaction? Finally, the fifth pillar of cloud value is sustainability. By leveraging AWS's highly efficient data centers rather than running their own, many organizations can minimize the environmental impact of their operations. AWS has over 10 years of experience migrating and modernizing enterprise workloads and working with thousands of customers to help them realize the full value of cloud. To support our customers in maximizing the value they can achieve, we offer unique programs, specialized services and tools, incentives, and competency partners that can proactively help customers optimize AWS infrastructure to reach their goals. When taking these five pillars of the cloud value framework together, you can see that there are myriad aspects of value by running on cloud. This is something that ANZ Bank recognized and has begun to realize even further as they migrate more and more workloads to cloud. ANZ Bank is one of the big four banks in Australia and offers a wide range of personal and institutional banking services, both domestically and worldwide. Here to speak with us today is Adrian Jans.
Thanks, Priya. If we look at ANZ's cloud strategy, it rolls up into group technology strategy and in turn, the bank's wider strategy. And the bank's strategy is focused around four key P's, which is our propositions, our platforms, our partnerships, and our people. Group technology strategy is laser focused on five key pillars, which is simplified engineering, actionable data, effective workforce, secure information, and healthier services. When we think about cloud more holistically, our strategy around that is to change in our operating model. So we want to be building less and assembling more. We want to be looking at how we exploit the cleanup opportunities in terms of decommissioning or sunsetting legacy applications. We want to embrace the step change in cost transparency and the variable cost environments that is made available through cloud. We want to embrace software as a service. We also want to be looking at how we migrate away from our legacy fleet and our data center environments. ANZ's cloud journey started back in 2020, where we started building out our core foundations. A number of our controls were unautomated and very tactical. We commenced our engagement with our regulator at that time. And as we look forward into 2021 and 2022, we built out our production platforms. We scaled them globally across multiple regions and countries. We implemented automated cloud controls and implemented a defined cloud control framework to support workloads at scale. At the end of 2022, we achieved 35% on cloud, and we moved a number of material workloads approved by our regulator at the time. As we look towards 2023 and taking all of the learnings that we've learned along the way, we're now migrating at pace. We're rehosting multiple applications per week. Our replatforms have come down dramatically from 20 plus weeks to now 10 to 15 weeks, and at a fraction of the cost, all within the last 12 months. We've targeted more complex workloads, and our cost transparency and self-service is now assisting in lowering the bar for experimentation on cloud. Today, I'm here to talk about two of our core replatforming apps, the home loan pricing and term deposit pricing or instant quote applications. They're both internally designed and developed on APIs. They provide internal systems with customer level discount home loan rates and term deposit rates based on a series of inputs by the consumers of those APIs. From an application perspective, we selected these apps based on an app assessment in partnership with AWS, the application team, and the core cloud and migration teams, and identified that these were the perfect candidates for ANZ's first replatforms for AWS. Both were made up of the same architecture and developed by the same team. Both were using GitHub, Bamboo CI/CD, and Artifactory for app development and pipelines, and OpenShift with MS SQL Server for on-prem. Based on that assessment, the target state was Bamboo, along with AWS, EKS, ECR, and RDS. As I'll get into shortly, this migration has significantly reduced the migration overhead. Workload teams are no longer constrained in terms of capacity or functionality. Using techniques like infrastructure as code and already blueprinted AWS managed services, the workload teams can instantly and safely deploy resources. And we've demonstrated this through experimentation of building a new modern front end. Moving to the cloud has given the workload team a better posture in terms of availability, security, DR, cost optimization, and observability. Additionally, uplift in engineering capability, cloud skills, observability, infrastructure as code, and DevOps practices. Our time to market through leveraging managed services, which is offloaded our undifferentiated heavy lifting. We've increased experimentation through deploying new full stack environments in minutes for POCs. We've stopped the guessing of capacity and we're now less reliant on infrastructure teams. And we now have a roadmap to leverage from a catalog of blueprinted AWS services. We've also achieved benefits in multiple different ways. To start with, cost savings. Apps were hosted on-premise on our OpenShift container environment, which had been running on extended support, and moving to cloud has reduced the risk of that and also reduced the cost for our application teams as they no longer need to maintain these asset life cycles going forward. When these apps lived on-prem, there was limited visibility into the cost. Post-migration, teams have far greater transparency and can see on a daily basis how much infrastructure decisions, choices, and actions are costing. As a result, we've seen a shift in our staff's behavior and where they're now wanting to minimize more cost. They're now looking real time at the utilization and making more informed decisions around what needs to be on and what can be shut down, what can be right-sized, and a number of other cost optimization measures. They've been so effective in cost optimization, even in this short span of time, they're now looking at re-baselining the cost of both of these apps, along with what's coming in flight and future migrations. Further, there is a cost reduction over a period of time as automation is backed into application build, config, and testing. And typically, automation saves upwards of 50% in ongoing effort for build and test activities. From a staff productivity perspective, we're getting our employees trained in new cloud-based skills, which is both good for them and good for us. When we first discussed moving these apps to AWS, the team couldn't really see the value and were slightly apprehensive. But now, they're cloud trained and experienced, spending less time on the basic operational tasks, becoming leaders in the organization, and learning to experiment and innovating faster. As a result, staff satisfaction has increased as teams are now working on the latest technologies. For example, many of the databases are now managed by our database as a service team instead of our app teams, freeing them up to focus on building products and service for our customers. From an operational resilience perspective, we've made material improvements here as well. Release deployments and integration testing have been made simpler. There are no longer application outages when it upgrades to new versions. Our applications are not limited by any infrastructure or scalability, so we can now support any number of customer requests. We're able to consistently deliver quality products that are stable and resilient. Optimized CI/CD pipelines allow us to build isolated environments, run tests, and therefore know what we're going into production with is of high quality. From an integration perspective, using our API mesh layer, we've been able to integrate across platforms. We're now a step ahead of our future app migrations, can easily communicate across platforms, have a service that can be ready and consumable immediately, and can readily identify points of failure across multiple platforms. This helps us triage and resolve issues faster. The platform has been designed to enable app teams to focus on applications and our customers. The platform patches and upgrades everything from the application up. This includes Kubernetes versions, security, tooling, and APIs. Finally, our applications are protected from new vulnerabilities. We see this in full flight through regular updates of the cloud platform controls. As we look at business agility, we have a number of new learnings here. We've been able to become more agile and proactively address needs of our application users. On-prem, it would have taken weeks, if not months, to provision new infrastructure for new products. POCs can quickly be deployed and integrated for products feature testing, which has increased our time to market significantly. For example, we are building new web applications to replace pricing sheets so there is a robust audit trail. Previously, we would have had to have asked for approvals, put in engagement processes, and start down a path without truly knowing if something like this would actually work. However, now we're able to self-service a POC for the business, show how it improves their experience, and get business buy-in before productionizing. App teams don't require large delivery teams to provision on-premise servers, which could take months due to backlog and prioritization. Now, end-to-end, we can deploy and get going in less than a week. Teams can now experiment and be in control of their own destiny and work collaboratively with the business from the start. App teams are more empowered to manage and run its own infrastructure with limited dependency on cloud platform teams, thereby increasing the responsiveness to the business requirements and needs of our customers. After moving to cloud, we're now seeing an increased appetite from other app teams to integrate with these pricing apps to better provide a customer experience. From a sustainability perspective, we're still evolving our cloud journey with the plan to reduce our data center footprint materially. ANZ is committed to supporting households, businesses, and financial practices to improve the environmental sustainability. Based on the 451 research study on sustainability, it is clear AWS customers reduce their workload carbon footprint and their power consumption. We also know that Amazon has committed to 80% renewable energy by 2024 and 100% by 2030, and that excites us in our own sustainability commitments. At ANZ, we've commenced a cloud optimization ambassador program targeted at identifying workloads and cost savings initiatives. Application teams have started placing instances into a schedule, shutting down at 7 p.m., reducing idle resources. Our databases as service teams have scheduled our shutdown periods for 12 hours over evenings for all non-prod environments. Whilst these seem insignificant actions, at scale across our global presence, we do believe will make a material impact to improving our environmental outcomes for migrating these workloads to cloud. So where to from here? The immediate future for these two pricing apps is to build out the app team's data operations, including building dashboards, optimizing costs, and evolving what good looks like. But the journey is far bigger than just these two applications we looked at today. Our migration journey has brought so many learnings, benefits, improvements to the business, our teams, and our customers. We've started scaling out data operations for cloud workloads and empowering self-service for workload optimization and cost savings. Whilst we continue to focus on moving workloads to cloud and providing better experiences and service for our customers, we're also embarking on modernizing across multiple layers, which include our applications, our databases, and our database infrastructure.
Let AWS help plan your strategy to help you meet your business goals. Migrate to the most extensive global cloud infrastructure for cost optimization, scale, security, performance, and resiliency. And modernize, leveraging AWS cloud-native tools for agile application development, advanced data analytics, and innovating faster than ever before. To help in this next stages of thinking through cloud, visit Skill Builder, our online center, to explore over 600 free digital courses, hands-on labs, and role-based games. Technology makes innovation possible, but it's people who will build a better tomorrow. Your time is now. Please complete the session survey, and thank you for watching.